Assalamu alaikum dear students. Today we will learn about overview and organization of computer. In this unit we will learn about history and development of computer, generations of computers, types of computers, applications of computers, parts of computers and storage. Unit 2. Overview and organization of computer. After completion of this unit, you will be able to describe history and development of computer, distinguish different generations of computer, classify different types of computers, describe types of computers, have knowledge about applications of computers, have knowledge about different parts of the computer, know about memory and storage. History and development of computer. The history of computer describes the advancement and growth of computer technology. It is divided into different eras and has its roots starting from prehistory era. Abacus machine. The abacus is a mechanical device which can perform basic arithmetic problems like addition, etc. This machine was the first machine invented in 4th century BC. Napier's bones. John Napier, a Scottish theologian and mathematician, invented logs in 1614, through which he was able to perform multiplication and division, and later on it was converted to addition and subtraction. William Schickard. William Schickard built a mechanical calculator in 1623, which was able to perform the process of multiplication. This device supported 6-digit capacity. Blaise Pascal. Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, built a mechanical calculator in 1642, which could add and subtract two numbers directly and multiply and divide by repetition. This device supported 8-digit capacity. Charles Babbage. Charles Babbage invented another device with the name of analytical engine, a mechanical computer that was able to perform basic mathematical problems at an average speed of 60 additions per minute. History and development of computer. The history of computer describes the advancement and growth of computer technology. It is divided into different eras and has its roots starting from prehistory era. Abacus machine. The abacus is a mechanical device which can perform basic arithmetic problems like addition, etc. This machine was the first machine invented in 4th century BC. Napier's bones. John Napier, a Scottish theologian and mathematician, invented logs in 1614, through which he was able to perform multiplication and division, and later on it was converted to addition and subtraction. William Schickard. William Schickard built a mechanical calculator in 1623, which was able to perform the process of multiplication. This device supported 6-digit capacity. Blaise Pascal. Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, built a mechanical calculator in 1642, which could add and subtract two numbers directly and multiply and divide by repetition. This device supported 8-digit capacity. Charles Babbage. Charles Babbage invented another device with the name of analytical engine, a mechanical computer that was able to perform basic mathematical problems at an average speed of 60 additions per minute. History and development of computer. Generations of computer. With the passage of time, several changes were made in computer technology to meet the challenges of the age. Modifications were classified into different periods, and later on these periods were also named as generations of the computer. First generation of computer, 1951 to 1958. The first generation computers used vacuum tubes technology. These computers are large in size, comprising of a large room. They required a large amount of power and generated a lot of heat. The first generation computers also used punch card and magnetic tape as an input device. Magnetic tapes were able to access large data, but they process it sequentially. Second generation of computer, 1959 to 1964. In the second generation of computers, transistors replaced vacuum tubes. Punch cards were used as an input device to feed the computer programs. Instructions. Magnetic tapes were also used as an input-output storage. Some high-level languages like Fortran, COBOL, and BASIC were also used. These are small-sized computers. Less heat is generated and they consume less energy as compared to the first generation computers. Third generation, 1965 to 1970. In third generation of computers, integrated circuits replaced transistors. Integrated circuits consists of thousands of transistors fabricated in a single silicon chip. These computers were more reliable, smaller in size, generated less heat, and required less power and energy. Keyboards and monitors were used as inputs and outputs. Pascal was used as a high-level language. Fourth generation, 1980. Fourth generation of computer was based on two technologies, large-scale integration, LSI, and very large-scale integration, VLSI. In LSI technology, about 30,000 electronic components were fabricated in a single chip, while in VLSI technology, about 1 million electronic components were fabricated in a single chip. IBM made personal computers using microprocessors. Keyboards and monitors were used as primary input and output devices. Fifth generation, late 1990s. In fifth generation computers, voice recognition was used as an additional special feature. Voice recognition is also called speech recognition. It is the ability of a device to receive and interpret dictation. Optical fiber technology was introduced for communication. Optical fiber is normally made of glass through which large amount of data can transfer in the form of light. Artificial intelligence technology was also introduced. Artificial intelligence acts like a human being. For example, robot artificial intelligence made the computers to have thinking power and reasoning. Classification of computers. Microcomputer. A microcomputer is derived from the word micro, which means smaller in size. It is also called a personal computer, because it is mostly used in homes for general purposes like making drawings, budgets, listening to music, etc. Microcomputers use microprocessors as its central processing unit. Laptop computers. Laptop computers are also called notebook computers. This type of computer is portable and compact in size. Laptops are popular because they are easy to carry anywhere, for example, while you are traveling. It can also be used with the help of its internal battery. Mini computer. A mini computer usually falls between a microcomputer and a mainframe. A mini computer supports hundreds of users simultaneously. For example, PEC Master, Toshiba DS1 and AS400. Mainframe. Mainframes were large cupboard-sized computers. These were expensive and their processing speed was extremely high. Mainframe computers were used to store, manage, and process large amounts of data that needed to be reliable, secure, and centralized. The main feature of mainframe computers was that it was capable of supporting thousands of users simultaneously. A mainframe computer had the capability to execute many programs running at the same time. For example, IBM 360, NEC mainframe. Handheld computer. Handheld computers are very much smaller in size. They can be easily carried out in hands. These computers use small keyboards and screens. Mostly handheld computers are designed to facilitate personal information manager functions such as a calendar and address books. Handheld computers are also called PDAs, palm tops, and pocket computers. For example, CS40, CK70, CK71. Palm top. These are computers which can be easily carried in hands or palms, and that is why these are called palm top computers. Palm tops are specifically designed for special functions like phone books and calendars. Palm tops use a special device called a pen as an input device. For example, Nokia 9500, Nokia E90, etc. PDA, Personal Digital Assistant. PDA stands for Personal Digital Assistant. PDA is a type of palm top computer or handheld device which contains features of computing, telephone, fax, and networking. PDAs also use pen-based device as an input rather than keyboard. For example, Nokia 770, Nokia N800, etc. Types of computers. According to the purpose, computers are divided into the following subclasses: digital computer, analog computer, hybrid computer. Digital computers. Digital computer processes information in the form of digits. Everything is described in two states, that is, 0 or 1, off or on. These computers are accurate but not as fast as analog. Digital computers serve a general purpose for daily life problems such as making home budgets, playing games, listening to music, etc. Analog computers. An analog computer recognizes data in physical and continuous form. Output of these computers is usually displayed on meter or graphs like voltage, pressure, speed, and temperature. Therefore, these computers are mostly used in the scientific laboratories. These computers are high speed but not as accurate as digital computers. Hybrid computer. Hybrid computers are a combination of analog and digital computers. Hybrid computers are especially helpful in science laboratories where both analog and digital data is required for processing. Applications of computer. Due to the remarkable progress of the computer technology, it is useful almost in every aspect of life. Some of the most important fields are education, business, banking, defense, entertainment. Education. Computer technology is playing a very vital role in education sector. Students get their study notes, tutorials, and even textbooks and solution manuals with the help of internet technology. It also enhances the students' learning and helps improve the quality of education. One of the great revolutions in education is e-learning. Business. Computer technology is playing a very important role in productivity and competitiveness of business. Sales and marketing department use internet to enhance sales and marketing. A customer can now easily buy and purchase products, and the payments can be made just by using smart cards, internet banking and electronic deposits, or even pay his bills online. Banking. Banking sector is also getting a great benefit from using computer technology. Internet banking is an example of modern banking where a customer can easily check his balance while sitting at home and can transfer funds without queuing or physical fatigue. In fact, computer technology has enormously saved the user's time. ATM is another example of modern banking sector. A user can now draw money through ATMs anywhere and anytime around the clock. Defense. The computer technology has productive applications in defense. Computer technology is used in intercontinental ballistic missiles, rockets that use GPS, global positioning systems, to help the missile to hit the specified target. Computer technology is used to track incoming missiles and hit them in the air. More importantly, the computer technology has the capability to design and test new systems. Entertainment. Computer technology has also provided enormously high opportunities for entertainment and pleasure. Computer technology has brought a great revolution in movies and cinema sector, introducing 3D technology, which enhances the quality of the graphics. Gaming has become an important part of the computer industry, where many companies are now developing games. Sports. In sports, computer technology is used for record keeping. Computer is used to collect and analyze the statistics and display the updated score. Computer also helps to sell tickets, create training programs, and even suggests diets for athletes. Important terms and computer parts. Buses. Buses are the electric paths through which data is transferred from one location to another location within a computer system. There are a number of different computer buses, which are as follows. Data bus. Data bus uses the combination of wires to transfer the data. Data bus is bi-directional. Address bus. An address bus is also called memory bus. It carries the memory addresses which are required by the microprocessor for reading and writing the data. An address bus works only in one direction. Control bus. The control bus is used to transfer control signals or commands generated by the CPU within the computer. This bus works in both directions. There are two important terminologies which are used to define the operations of computer buses. This includes the following. Width. The size of the bus is also called its width. Width means how much data can be transferred at one time. Clock speed. Every bus has its own data transfer. Has its own transfer speed, which is called a clock speed. It is measured in megahertz. For example, if speed of bus is 100 Mbps, it means 100 mega transfer in 1 second. Computer ports. Computer ports are basically an interface or the connector and external devices can plug. There are 3 types of ports. Serial port, parallel port, USB port. Serial port. Serial port is used to attach serial devices and it can transfer data one bit at a time. That is why it is slow in processing. Serial ports are also known as communication ports or RS232C ports. Mouse and modem can be attached in these ports. Parallel ports. It consists of 25 pins. This port is normally used for connections of printers and other parallel devices. A parallel port is capable of transferring 8 bits of data at one time. Therefore, parallel ports are faster than serial ports. USB or Universal Serial Bus. Universal Serial Bus is a serial bus used to attach every serial device. USB is a plug and play bus. That is why every device is now converted to USB ports like printers, scanners, and digital cameras, etc. Almost 127 devices can be plugged in this bus. Microprocessors. Microprocessor is also called the brain of the computer. Microprocessor is normally in the form of a silicon chip containing millions of transistors fabricated on it and is called CPU, Central Processing Unit. Intel and AMD are well-known brands of microprocessors. Microprocessors consist of the following different components. ALU or Arithmetic and Logical Unit. The Arithmetic and Logical Unit is an important part of the CPU. It has the capability to do arithmetic and logical operations. Arithmetic operations are simple mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division. Logical operations performs comparisons operations like equal to, not equal to, less than, greater than. Control unit. Control unit controls and coordinates all the components and operations of the computer. Control unit brings instructions from memory units and passes to ALU for execution in an appropriate order. Memory unit. A memory unit is a temporary location inside the CPU for storing data and instruction temporarily for processing the data. Memory and storage. Primary memory. Primary memory is also called main memory of the computer. Primary memory is online memory which is directly accessible to CPU. Data and instructions are stored temporarily in memory to be executed. These are memory chips mounted in the motherboard. Random access memory or RAM. Random access memory randomly selects memory location where data can be stored. CPU gets data and instruction for processing and after processing, CPU stores results in this memory. RAM is also called volatile because when a computer system is shut down, all the data existing in memory is erased. More RAM increases the performance of the computer. RAM is further divided into the following categories. Dynamic Random Access Memory or DRAM, Static Random Access Memory or SRAM. DRAM. DRAM stands for Dynamic Random Access Memory. In DRAM, a combination of capacitor and transistor is used to store data in the form of charge. A capacitor loses charge after some time, so it needs to be refreshed to maintain charge and data. DRAM is slower but cheaper memory, so it is used as system memory. SRAM. SRAM stands for Static RAM. In SRAM, combination of transistor and flip-flop are used to store data. It does not need refreshing. Static RAM is generally used for cache memory, which can be accessed more quickly than DRAM. SRAM is faster than DRAM but is costly, so it cannot be used as a system memory. Read-only memory, ROM. ROM is also primary memory, which is only readable, meaning data can only be read but new data cannot be entered in this memory. This memory is non-volatile and data cannot be erased when power supply is switched off of computer. Data copied when this memory chip is manufactured. Types of ROM are PROM, EPROM and EEPROM. Secondary storage. Secondary memory is also called secondary storage, auxiliary or baking storage. These devices are used to store large amount of data permanently. These are called non-volatile memory because after shutting off the computer, the data is not erased. Types of storage media, hard disks, optical disks, hard disks. A hard disk is fixed drive inside the computer. Hard disk is primarily used to store large amount of data and also provides a very quick access to retrieve the data or programs. Hard disk is available in different sizes like 10 GB or 500 GB, etc. Optical disk. An optical disk is used also as a secondary storage medium. Data can be written and read using a low-powered laser beam. Optical disks are available in the following formats: compact disk or CD, digital versatile disk or DVD. Compact disk, CD. A compact disk is non-volatile storage medium which is used for recording about 700 MB data. Compact disks are available in the following types: CDR, CDRW, CDR. CDR, a compact disk on which data can be written only once, and therefore CDR is called read-only memory. Data cannot be erased from CDR. CDRW. CDRW, CD rewritable, is used to write the data more than one time and can also erase the previous contents of the data. CDRW is a little expensive than CDR. DVD. DVD, digital versatile disk, has the capability to store large amount of data, movies, than CD. DVDs are rapidly replacing CDs just because of their higher capacity and performance. DVDs are further classified into the following types: DVD-R, recordable. DVD-R is used to record the data only one time. It cannot be re-recorded or rewritten due to the nature of DVD-R. DVD-RW, rewritable. DVD-RW is used to record the data multiple times. However, previous data can also be erased from it. Motherboard of computer system. The circuit board of the computer is called the motherboard of the computer. All components can be attached directly and indirectly to this board, including microprocessor, memory, storage devices, serial and parallel ports and expansion slots, etc.